Warring parties in Yemen have ravaged the country since March 2015 and contributed to what the UN calls the world's worst humanitarian crisis. Almost 25 million people need some form of aid, including millions of malnourished children. The country's healthcare system has almost collapsed and has struggled to cope with cholera and other disease outbreaks. COVID-19 has spread unchecked due to the stigma of being infected with the virus and a shortage of medical supplies, healthcare centers, and health workers. This has made an already dire situation even worse.
الوباء هو عجزة الدول العظمى أمام هذا الوباء ولكن كيف بدولة مثل اليمن ومستشفيات متهالكة؟
Since the Houthis took control of northern and central Yemen in late 2014, humanitarian agencies have worked hard to get aid to millions of Yemenis, but the armed group has severely restricted their work. They have delayed or blocked aid projects, heavily interfered with projects they do approve, diverted aid, and attacked aid staff and their property. Yemeni government authorities who control the south are also increasingly interfering with aid agencies' work. Aid obstruction has denied millions of Yemenis access to food, water, healthcare, sanitation, and other life-saving services. The obstruction has also affected aid agencies' ability to do everything they can to prevent the spread of COVID-19, such as by blocking primary healthcare projects and access to the country's underserviced hospitals and clinics.
عانينا معاناة شديدة من حيث قلة تواجد العلاجات، قلة الإمكانيات الصحية توفرها كأجهزة، كمرافق صحية متكاملة.
نعاني من نقص أدوات الحماية للطاقم الطبي كاملاً في قسم العزل وللمرضى.
In June 2020, international donors slashed their funding for aid agencies in Yemen, in part because of the Houthis' long-standing and increasing aid obstruction. The lack of money has forced aid agencies to cut many of their life-saving services. The Saudi-led coalition fighting the Houthis has also attacked medical facilities and imposed measures blocking and then restricting the country's access to essential goods. However, to end the current aid crisis, the Houthis and the Yemeni government should immediately end their aid obstruction and allow aid agencies to work without interference to help millions of people in need.